Hello everyone, it's Nadine. Today we'll be testing out the new CoverGirl Spring Collection lipsticks. As you beautiful people know, this is about the product, not the people behind it. Any tiff you may have with them, please cast it away because this is a channel of positive energy. Okay? Thank you. My lips are so fucking sore. I'm actually doing the wear time test right now. What you're about to see, I filmed it way earlier. I filmed like 4 videos today, and in one of them I cut my hair. But I'm currently finishing up with wear time tests, and for the colors I chose Never Say Never, and then on the middle some of Back Talk. But let's get right into trying these little bitches on, and then I'll tell you exactly what I think of these. First up is the lip glosses, and we're starting off with Tabby T's. This is actually really, really pretty. It's comfortable on the lips, but it does kind of have that sticky feel, but the color is beautiful. It's peach with little tiny gold flecks in it. It does enhance your lips without being like pow color. Next up we have Cantaloupe. This is another beautiful gloss. There's barely any color to it, but it does add that little bit of gold shimmer to it. I think I might actually like this better than the other one, but it's definitely nude, yet it has that really pretty frost effect to it. Here we have Ninth Life. This is another beautiful shade, and I love that it's so pigmented. Like, this is very, very rich and luxurious looking on the lips, but it feels so comfortable. These do all have that typical glossy kind of feel, but they're not what I like to call blowjob glosses, which I'm sure we've all had one of those. It feels like a certain fluid on your lips, and it dries down like a certain fluid on your lips. Not comfortable at all. These actually dry down very comfortable and almost feel like a cream lipstick. This next shade is Wine Feline, and this is such a beautiful deep berry color, but because it is that deep color, it's almost a little bit splotchy. Like, once you rub it around on your lips, the color disperses, but overall, it is the teensiest bit splotchy. But the more you rub your lips around, the less splotchy it becomes, but then the color becomes lighter. Or two. Oh, that's pretty. This next one is Kitty Karma, and holy shit, I fucking love this. Like, this is literally me in a lip gloss. Like, it's pink, it's sparkly, and it's clearly the gayest thing in the room. I love it. This is Candy Cat, and honestly, I really like this shade too. A lot of people probably wouldn't, but this reminds me of Amanda Bynes' Crazy Day, so of course I love it. Which, unfortunately, is more than I can say for this shade, which is Pounce. I don't know that I dislike this color, but at the same time, it's just not sitting on me right. Like, I really want to be one of those people who could rock this, but I don't think I am, but I'm still trying to make it work. I don't know, what do you think? However, I do love this deeper purple catnip. It really doesn't go on that purple. It looks more fuchsia than anything, but I really, really like it. Like, this is the perfect spring color. And here we have Indigo Cat. It's not that I dislike this color, because I actually do really like it. Like, it's giving off grape Kool-Aid vibes, but it is so splotchy, and you have to put quite a bit on for the color to really build up, and then it just goes on your teeth, so it's a little bit messy. And then once you rub your lips together to make it not splotchy, it becomes even more splotchy, so I don't care for this one. Ooh, this is pretty though. This one is Purple Paws, and I really, really like this one too. It's like that other purple where it was like fuchsia, but this has gold flecks in it. Very, very pretty. Here we have Cobalt Kitty, and I'm not gonna lie, this one is definitely not one of my favorites. Like, it's giving me serious hypothermic lips, like no joke. But I do think there are certain people in this world that could rock the fuck out of this. Unfortunately, I'm not one of them. Love the uniqueness, just don't love it on me. This next one is White Cadillac, and I look like I've either been eating Coke for breakfast or I'm in a homemade got milk commercial. I love that this is so unique, but because it's a lip gloss, I'm really not able to be super precise with it, and you can tell because it's so colorful. I think maybe combined or put in the middle of other lip glosses, this would be amazing, but on its own, I don't think I could rock it. And finally for the lip glosses, we have 405 Double Platinum Melting Pout, and I really do like this, but it's not at all what I was expecting. Like, in the tube, it actually looks holographic, and when I first put it on, it looked like liquid metal, but now that it's on, it's almost like grayish but sparkly. I don't know that I like it. But I feel like if you use this as a liquid lipstick topper, this would be amazing. But on its own, definitely not. And it actually does say liquid top coat, so I definitely used it wrong. First up for liquid lipsticks, we have 310 Coral Chronicles. And this shade is beautiful. It does look very similar to my natural shade, but it just evens everything out. And it went on so smoothly. It dried down really quickly, and it doesn't really feel like there's much on my lips. It's very, very comfortable, especially for being a matte lipstick. This next one is 305 Ballerina, and yet again, another beautiful pinky tone. This one is a little bit lighter than the other one, almost on the more ashy side, but I still think the color is absolutely beautiful. It was a little bit on the patchy side because it's so light, but I did put 2 layers on, and it feels totally okay. This next one is 335 Champagne Showers, and I love this color so much. Like, it's pink with a little hint of brown in it. So pretty. This one is 340 Current Nude, and this is really pretty. I don't know that it looks that good on me. It's kind of like a dusty mauve-y color, and those dusty colors don't always go good with my my skin tone, but I do really like this shade. This shade is called Insider, and it's very, very close to the last shade, but for some reason I like this one more. Like, it's got a little bit more purple or brown or something in it. I don't know, I just really like it. This next shade is 120 Rebel, and oh my god, I fucking love this color. Like, this is the kind of color that I love to wear. It's so damn comfy, but I'm not gonna lie, it's not one swipe to get full coverage. You do have to kind of layer it in order for it to not be splotchy. But once it's layered, I'm in fucking heaven. And I love this next one as well. It's 100 Cakewalk, and that is honestly a perfect name for it because it reminds me of like a caramel butterscotch cupcake. But then as I say that, I'm also reminded of a terrible, terrible porn movie that had to do with cake. Oh, I hope you don't know what I'm talking about. But as for this color, I would never guess that I would gravitate towards this, but I really like it, and I'm loving the yellow undertone that it has. Here we have 345 Paradise Lost, and if you know me, you know that I fucking love brown lipsticks. Like, brown is my favorite lipstick color of all time. And this is definitely no exception, but I'm noticing on my camera screen, it almost looks green on camera, but in person, it's a beautiful, rich, like Hershey syrup brown. Not sure what's up with that. But I'm really curious to know how Cakewalk would look in the middle, so let's go ahead and try that. Oh my gosh, I really like that. I mean, it definitely takes a certain kind of person to actually like this, but I am one of those and I love it. I just don't know why it looks green. Hopefully that's just me. This beautiful gray is called 355 Gray Matter, and I actually really fucking adore this color. Like, I never would have guessed that I'd like most of these shades, but it looks so fucking pretty, at least in person. I mean, you definitely have to create a makeup look and make this work, but I feel like so many people could rock the shit out of this. You do kind of have to build it up to get the full color, but to me, it's just such a unique color. Like, I have a friend who gets her nails done super matte in this shade, and it's like, oh my god, bitch, you so rich. And I have the same exact feeling about this next one, which is 200 Clean Slate. It's a beautiful brownish gray. To me, it just looks expensive, and the people who could rock this would rock the fuck out of it and look so damn good. But it's certainly only for a select group of people. Like, not everybody could pull off this color. And I'm still not positive that I'm one of them, but this hoe still loves it. And I also love 160 Bay. Like, this shit is legit bay. But I'm noticing that on camera, it almost looks like pumpkin orange, but in person, it's salmon, it's bright, it's beautiful. It's such a beautiful springtime color. Like, I don't know anybody that this wouldn't look good on. This next one is 300 Secret. I'm sorry, we're kind of all over the color board today, but we're back here with a pinky color. And this is my shit. Like, this is almost reminiscent of Kat Von D's Lolita. I fucking love this. I could literally wear this with any kind of makeup and it would still look good. Like, this is such a beautiful shade. Oh, you guys, this one is killing me so much. It's 150 Flamingo, and this color is so fucking pretty. I love it. It's almost like a Barbie Malibu pink. Like, when I wear this color, I want to dye my hair blonde, buy an overpriced car, and move to Santa Monica. I love it. It's another perfect spring color, and honestly, this is perfect for summer, too. This lovely purple 170 Major Moment, I actually really, really like, too. And these kind of purples typically make your teeth look yellow, but not this one. Like, it's actually really pretty. And it is one of those shades that's borderline Barney purple that I wouldn't typically gravitate towards, but I actually really like this. Like, I would love to use this in one of my tutorials. This next one is 320 Back Talk, and no fucking joke, this is literally everything that I want in life. It is vampy, it is berry, it is bold, I love it. But I did have to layer it up a good 3 or 4 times for it not to be patchy, and even at that, it is still a little bit patchy, which is to be expected with this kind of color. But I still adore it. This is definitely one of my all-time faves out of this collection. Here we have this deep, deep color, 325 Never Say Never, and I'm not gonna lie, I'm not exactly sure what color this is. It might be like a deep purple, but it also might be a deep brown. Either way, I do really like it, but I did have to put like 6 coats of this on just for it not to be patchy, and it is still a little bit patchy. Nonetheless, I do really like this color. Like, it's deep and dark, it's vampy, and I love that, but I would probably top this over like a darker liner just so that your bright pink lip isn't showing through. Up next is 315 All Nighter, and this red is so beautiful. It's like one of those pinky reds that's universally flattering. I love it. It does look a bit darker on camera. Like, in person, it does look kind of like a blue undertone, but a light blue undertone. I don't know, it just screams, notice me, and if somebody were wearing this color, you probably would notice them. Somebody would also notice you if you were wearing this color, which is 350 Supermodel, and I actually really, really like this color. It was a little bit patchy, so I did have to build it up like 2 or 3 times, but once it's on,
I really like it.
And we've tried navy lipsticks on this channel before, and I just did not like them. But this one, I really love. I don't know that it really complements my skin tone, but this is definitely the best navy that I've ever used. Somebody's playing Ed Sheeran really fucking loudly. I swear to God, if somebody's getting engaged in the parking lot, I'm gonna go down there and whoop their asses.
Oh, thank Jesus, it stopped.
And last but not least, we have this beautiful, bold black, a lipstick after my own fucking heart. Black lipsticks are always a big hit or a miss. There is never anywhere in between, and I think this is actually a hit. Going on initially, it is a little bit patchy. You do have to build it up, but then once you build it up, it looks beautiful. Like, I'm not really able to see my original lip color. But I do notice that, unlike pretty much all of the other colors, I can feel this one on my lips. Like, this one is the most drying for some reason. But that might be because I did just swatch like 30 lipsticks. Either way, I do really like it. Is it the best black in the world? No, but for being a drugstore black, it's pretty damn good. And that is all of them. Holy shit, my lips still feel tingly from trying all those on. But overall, I actually do really like these lipsticks. They're not at all the one swipe full coverage kind of lipstick, which I actually kind of appreciate, because for somebody like me who isn't the best at applying liquid lipsticks, it allows for a little bit more forgiveness. So for example, the lip that I have today, in order to get absolute full coverage, I think I had to use like 2 or 3 layers of this deep purple and then just a single layer of this light purple, and I was able to get the look I wanted. But other than that, I think this lipstick is really fucking good. Like, I've been wearing this for maybe like 5 hours and it still looks the exact same. It feels very lightweight. It's not drying my lips out. I really like it. Do I recommend this product? I do, but only if you're wanting a buildable formula. Like, this is not the super high pigmented, one swipe full coverage kind of thing. If you're wanting that kind of product when you buy this, you're gonna be disappointed. It's buildable, it's breathable, there's a shit ton of shades, so I really don't have that many complaints about it. But there you go, and a big ass thank you to CoverGirl for sending these my way. Like always, please be sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell down below so that you're notified anytime I upload a new video. Don't forget, my newest collection of highlighters, including Black Ice, which does change from black to white, is available at thepublix.com. Also, my latest album, Kiss of Fame, is available everywhere online that music is sold. Thank you so much to everyone who's supporting them. Comment down below, let me know what you thought of this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe. You can follow me on Snapchat, Instagram, and Twitter at OfficialLady, and you can follow me online at thepublix.com. Thank you so much for watching. I love you all, and I will see you again soon. Bye.